So you didn't get any of the drilling. I've had it turned off on me. So, yeah, there we go. These are the drilled holes for the Noga mount. So, then we're going to put thumb screws in on the end and on the bottom. And we'll be all set. I'll make a couple thumb screws up so you can just kind of move them around. Probably. We'll do that tomorrow. Hey. Alright, we're getting set up here. We're going to drill four holes in the thing. One on each end and right here. These will be for the thumb screws. To lock in things. To lock in the indicators. But I'm not going to go where I put that center punch mark. It's a little too close to that hole, so I want to be able to make at least a 3/8 thumb screw. So we're going to just bring it over a little touch more. Still on the center line of the holes, but just out a little bit farther. That's all. Maybe right there. Yeah, we don't need to really spot these. So I'm going to drill 1032. This is the number 21 drill. The smaller taps are pretty, taps are hard, and it's hard to get a manual truck there, a keyless chuck to grab them sometimes. Little bigger ones I don't have a problem with, but only smaller ones. I threw in a piece of 3/8 stainless. So I'm going to make the little thumb screw, the knob part of the thumb screw out of. I'm just going to use a 1032 brass screw for the stub part of the screw. I'm just gonna clean this up.
fixing it.
All right, I got a spring center in. Bunch of, put some anchor lube in there. Brand new tap. Let's hope we don't break it. Being a 50% hole, usually goes in pretty easy. There we go. That's all the way. Now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to pull it out, do a little polish on that real quick. Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to take it over to the mill. And I'm going to see if I can just mill some slots, little slots in there just to make it a little grabby. So you got something good to grab on. I got a good handful of these little these pieces of 3/8 stainless right here. Scavenged them out of a tool holding board. So yeah, well they're only gonna be about 3/8 of an inch long or so anyway. So we're just gonna mill some slots around it. Hopefully. So I got that piece in a feisty collet, in a, collet block, a six-sided collet block. And I'm going to pick up the edge, come over here, pick the edge, divide by two, and we get this set on center, and all I have is a 3/8 ball mill. We'll see if that's hopefully that's not too big. We'll see what happens. Go over here to zero. It's going to touch there, get a zero on the Z. Okay, 20 thousandths. Came out really nice. I don't know if you can tell. Let me take it out of the block. And I'll show you. There you guys go. Came out nice.
even look even. That's a plus, huh? Okay, we're gonna put back in the lathe, and we'll part these off and chamfer the edges and get two cool looking thumb nuts. So the hole depth's not deep enough for me to get 2/3 one, so we're gonna go 5/16. We should be able to do that. See how slow we gotta go here to part this off. There we go, we just clean off those little tits on there. I have two really nice little nuts. Okay, I've gingerly set that nut, one of those nuts in there. We're just gonna clean up that the back sides of them. Hardening anything, and then a little quick chamfer. Show you how they came out. Nice little spline type nut. Alright, we'll clean up that other one and then we'll get the screws in them.